بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.
My dear respected brothers and sisters to our weekly class of Al-Quran Al-Kareem and Tajweed. So Alhamdulillah, in this class Al-Quran, we study one page of Al-Quran Al-Kareem, reciting one page together, and then I recite myself. After that, I tell you about the tafsir, the meaning of the ayat, and about the tajweed, the rules of tajweed of the ayat. And after we finish that, we have hadith. Every week, we take one hadith from the book of Riyadh al-Salihin. If you have a copy, the book of Riyadh al-Salihin. Yes, this book. This book, Riyadh al-Salihin. This book of hadith written by Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah. And this book, I recommended, brothers and sisters, if you can get copy of this one to keep in your house. And this book is very famous. So I think you can find the Indonesian translation, you can find Bangladeshi translation, you can find many languages. This book, Alhamdulillah, have a lot of chapters. So each chapter having ayat and hadith. So by this book, Alhamdulillah, you can get many ahadith of the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and most of the ahadith inside Riyadh al-Salihin, most of the ahadith are sahih, are correct. Okay, it's different of some other books. This book have many ahadith. We can say 97% sahih. So mashallah. So every week after Quran, We talk all this from this book and then give some explanation about the hadith. Today, inshallah, we'll recite Surat An-Naml. Surat An-Naml. The page number 381. All brothers, okay. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولقد أرسلنا إلى ثمود أخاهم صالحا ولقد أرسلنا إلى ثمود أخاهم صالحا أن اعبدوا الله أن اعبدوا الله فإذا هم فريقان يختصمون فإذا هم فريقان يختصمون قال يا قوم لم تستعجلون بالسيئة قبل الحسنة قال يا قوم لم تستعجلون بالسيئة قبل الحسنة؟ لولا تستغفرون الله لعلكم ترحمون. لولا تستغفرون الله لعلكم ترحمون. قالوا اطيرنا بك وبمن معك، قالوا اطيرنا بك وبمن معك، قال طائركم عند الله، قال طائركم عند الله، بل أنتم قوم تفتنون. بل أنتم قوم تفتنون. وكان في المدينة تسعة رهط. وكان في المدينة تسعة رهط يفسدون في الأرض ولا يصلحون. يفسدون في الأرض ولا يصلحون. قالوا تقاسموا بالله، قالوا تقاسموا بالله لنبيتنه وأهله ثم لنقولن لنبيتنه وأهله ثم لنقولن ثم لنقولن لوليه ما شهدنا مهلك أهله ثم لنقولن لوليه ما شهدنا مهلك أهله مهلك أهله وإنا لصادقون. وإنا لصادقون. ومكروا مكرا ومكرنا مكرا. ومكروا مكرا ومكرنا مكرا. وهم لا يشعرون. وهم لا يشعرون. فانظر كيف كان عاقبة مكرهم. فانظر كيف كان عاقبة مكرهم. أنا دمرناهم. أنا دمرناهم وقومهم أجمعين. وقومهم أجمعين. فتلك بيوتهم خاوية بما ظلموا. فتلك بيوتهم خاوية بما ظلموا. إن في ذلك لآية لقوم يعلمون. إن في ذلك لآية لقوم يعلمون. وأنجينا الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون. وأنجينا الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون. ولوطا إذ قال لقومه أتأتون الفاحشة. ولوطا إذ قال لقومه أتأتون الفاحشة. وأنتم تبصرون. وأنتم تبصرون. أئنكم لتأتون الرجال شهوة. أئنكم لتأتون الرجال شهوة. شهوة من دون النساء. شهوة من دون النساء. بل أنتم قوم تجهلون. بل أنتم قوم تجهلون. الحمد لله we recite it together. Now inshallah I will recite for you. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولقد أرسلنا إلى ثمود أخاهم صالحا أن اعبدوا الله فإذا هم فريقان يختصمون. قال يا قوم لم تستعجلون بالسيئة قبل الحسنة لولا تستغفرون الله لعلكم ترحمون. قالوا اطيرنا بك وبمن معك، قال طائركم عند الله بل أنتم قوم تفتنون. وكان في المدينة 9 رهط يفسدون في الأرض ولا يصلحون. قالوا تقاسموا بالله لنبيتنه وأهله ثم لنقولن لوليه ما شهدنا مهلك أهله وإنا لصادقون. ومكرنا مكرا وهم لا يشعرون. فانظر كيف كان عاقبة مكرهم أنا دمرناهم وقومهم أجمعين. فتلك بيوتهم خاوية بما ظلموا إن في ذلك لآية لقوم يعلمون. وأنجينا الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون. ولوطا إذ قال لقومه أتأتون الفاحشة وأنتم تبصرون. أئنكم لتأتون الرجال شهوة من دون النساء بل أنتم قوم تجهلون. الحمد لله ورسالة الدعايات الحمد لله. ناو ده تفسير ده meaning of the آيات. From the first ayah of today talking about the story of Prophet صالح عليه السلام. صالح عليه السلام. الله سبحانه وتعالى sent صالح to which tribe؟ ها؟ ثمود. 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 فرعاد. هود. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى sent prophet هود for عاد. وإلى عاد الله القرآن الله سبحانه وتعالى said وإلى عاد أخاهم هودا. Okay. And then sent to ثمود صالح عليه السلام. Okay. صالح. سبحان الله the ثمود people they were very strong people. Very strong people. And they used to dig the mountains to make their houses inside. And if you think about that time, not now, at that time, the mountains are very stone, very hard. And those people, in out of their power, they used to make their houses inside. They dig the mountain to make the house inside. And subhanAllah, until now, it's remain. If you go to سعودية أرابيا you can find مدائن صالح the place of ثمود سبحان الله you can find they dig the mountains and they have the rooms they have even they have which we can say like now for example the city office or something like this they had also everything there remain Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it remain for people to see and to say subhanallah those people very strong and Allah destroyed them Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to them Salih alayhi salam and the da'wah of anbiya very simple لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله invited them to توحيد but سبحان الله even the كلمة of توحيد is very simple لا إله إلا الله but it's hard for the hearts of some people hard to accept There is only one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the kuffar of Mecca, they said, according to the ayat in Surah Sad, أَجَعَلَ الْآلِهَةَ إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا إِنَّ هَذَا لَشَيْءٌ عُجَابٌ They used to say, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants to make All gods, only one. It's very strange. Subhanallah. Even the people of Mecca and the Arab people at the time, they believe in Allah. They know Allah. But when you ask them why you are worshipping many gods, many idols, they said, because we cannot go to Allah direct. We have to go to someone to be in between us and Allah. Huh? Look, Shaitan, how misguiding. In our aqidah, there is nothing between you and Allah. If you want anything, you just ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No need to go to someone to be in between you and Allah. Very simple. So Thamud people, they rejected the da'wah of Salih. And of course, they said, show us some mu'jiza, some miracle that you are Nabi. Okay, you are Nabi. Show us some miracles. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give Salih one miracle. Which one? The camel, yes, the camel. She camel, yes, she camel. She camel, you understand she camel? Means the camel which have baby, okay? This camel, how came? From rock. Look, subhanAllah, to the mu'jiza. The Thamud people came to one big rock and then by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this rock open and then from inside camel she camel pregnant camel came if you are in that time and you see by your own eyes miracle who can do this Allah only Allah can do this But subhanAllah, those people also, even they saw the miracles by their own eyes, but they didn't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And according to the ayat which you recited today, they had a plan to kill the camel. Even I didn't say to you, this camel after giving birth, she used to give milk. This milk for all the tribe. They can drink from this milk. But Thamud, but Salih said, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this milk will be one day for all of you and the other day for the baby. So you allow to take one day by day. One day you take, one day no. Okay, like this. But subhanallah, they decided to kill the camel. And the one who killed it, his name not mentioned in Al-Quran. His name not mentioned in Al-Quran. But it's mentioned in Sunnah, the Hadith. About the name of that person mentioned in the Hadith. They gathered in one night and they drank khamr, and one of them, he was appointed to kill the camel. After he killed the camel, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed Thamud. And from that time until now, nobody can sit in this town. Even the sunnah, the guidance of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when you pass, don't stay for a long time. I want to pass, go to some place, and this, the town of Salih. What I have to do according to the sunnah, to go quick. Don't stay. In Ghazwat Tabuk, this also one benefit of the seerah. In Ghazwat Tabuk, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed near to the town of Salih, Thamud. But he gave advice to the Sahaba. Pass quick and don't drink or don't use the water there. Don't use the water. Why? Because still the la'na, the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, still there. So even the water, don't touch the water. It's cursed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in the ayat here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the ayah 52, فَتِلْكَ بُيُوتُهُمْ, this is their houses, خَاوِيَة, empty, there is no one there, بِمَا ظَلَمُوا, because of their wrong actions. Subhanallah. Of course, with Salih alayhi salam, some mu'min people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said Salih and the mu'min people. Ayah 53. أنجينا الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون. We saved the believers who had taqwa. We saved them from these punishments. Then the last two ayat talking about the story of Lut alayhi salam. وَلُوطًا إِذْ قَالَ لِقَوْمِهِ, remember Lut when he said to his people, you are doing or you are committing fahisha, a very major sin by your action. And the last ayah, you are going to man to man, not man to woman as a natural man to woman, okay, but you are going man to man, and this is the reason واي الله سبحانه وتعالى destroyed them. ان شاء الله the next week, next week we'll study the next ayat which will complete the story of Prophet Lut عليه السلام. Yes brother. I also forgot the name, but I can inshallah remember. Okay, inshallah, I will remember. Thank you. Thank you for asking this question. The name of the person who killed the camel. Now let's go to the tajweed. Tajweed. Wala qad falqala. Falqala for dal. Wala qad. So dal we make qalqala. And we said the letters of qalqala are five letters. Qutb, Jad, Qaf, Qa, Ba, Jim, Dal. These are the letters of Qalqalah in Al-Quran. When you have one letter of these letters with سكون سكون like here we say ولا قد ولا قد ولا قد so you see دال with سكون when we have any letter of قلقلة with سكون we make قلقلة قلقلة means to move the letter like now I said wala qad look qad the dal is moving qad this we say qalqala so qalqala when we have sukun sometimes the sukun we have two types of sukun sukun asli sukun asli like this one we say sukun asli you can see but we have sometimes sukun عارض سكون عارض like قل هو الله in the مصحف دال having تنوين أحد دون like this but because when we stop this تنوين became سكون So this sukun, we call that sukun عارض. Sukun عارض, because you stop. So if you have sukun asli or sukun عارض, you make qalqala. For the five letters only, this one. قطب جد, قطب جد. قطب جد, قاف, قا, با, جيم, دال. وَلَا قَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا أرسلنا also here the lam أرسل لام this lam إظهار make it clear because some people make mistake say أرسلنا like this أرسلنا they don't pronounce the lam so the proper is to pronounce them أرسلنا إلى ثمود أخاهم صالحا so we make إظهار we say إظهار حلقي when we have نون سكون or تنوين and after that one of six letters as I said before better inshallah next times to bring one note with you to write after me otherwise it will gone for نون سكون and تنوين if we have همزة هاء عين غين حاء خاء six letters Remember this one. If you have one of these letters coming after noon sukoon, noon sukoon, or tanween, 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 tanween dhamma, or tanween fatha, or tanween kasra. If you have noon sukoon, tanween, and after that one of this, you have to make this one. We say اظهار حلقي, اظهار حلقي, to make it very clear. Like here, you say صالحاً أن, صالحاً, you make صالحاً very clear, صالحاً أن, okay, أن يعبدوا, the second one, this one, how to pronounce أعبدو. How to make this alif a or u, which one, or e, which one, a e u, which one? So brother said any other? Actually, here this alif will be u, 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 u'budu, u'budu. How to know? Someone asked how to know. Okay, go to the third letter. 1, 2, 3. Ba having dhamma. Ba having dhamma. So when you see one like this one and then the letter number 3 having dhamma, then the first one also will be dhamma. So it will be u, u'budu, u'budu. Okay? But when another words, like this one. Like this one. The third one having fatha. Here it will be E kasra. E. So dhamma, dhamma. Fatha, kasra. Kasra, kasra. So it means we have only two, E or U. Okay, E or U. U when the third one having dhamma. E when the third one having fatha or kasra. I will say E. Okay, this for the verbs, not for nouns, because I know maybe some brother of you will say, but we have like some words, we say we don't say E. This one noun, not verb. Okay? Noun. Like for example, Allah. Say Allah. Like this one. You say but this noun, but I am talking about verb. I'budu verb. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. Ihdina, also verb. Ihdidi dal kasra. Third one, third letter kasra. So I say ihdina. Alhamdulillah. You say a noun, yes, because alhamdu this noun. Noun. Okay, but this rule for verb, not noun. Okay. أن يعبدوا. Of course, when you connect an with أعبدوا, this ألف will be dropped. So you go direct. أن يعبدوا. Yes. أن يعبدوا الله فإذا هم فريقان يختصمون. قال يا قوم لم تستعجلون بالسيئة قبل ها قلقلة باء قبل الحسنة لولا تستغفرون الله لعلكم ترحمون. قالوا اطيرنا. So اطيرنا verb. This alif will be E or U, which one? Look to the third letter, huh? Okay, this maybe need to be written. So this alif will be A or E or U, E or U. Look, what is the third letter? Number three. This ta having shadda. It means this ta, two ta. This ta is two. طاء سكون وسطاء فتحة. الطاء. So this will be E. So اطيرنا. اطيرنا. But here because we connect, it will disappear. So it will be قالوا اطيرنا. بك وبمن معك. إضغام نون سكون with ميم. إضغام with غن. قال طائركم. مد واجب متصل فور حركات. طائركم. عند الله. إخفاء حقيقي. يس. بل أنتم إخفاء حقيقي. قوم تفتنون. إخفاء حقيقي. وكان في المدينة تسعة رهط يفسدون. رهط يفسدون. إضغام وذغنة. في الأرض ولا يصلحون. قالوا تقاسموا بالله. سبحان الله. This talking about the people who gathered to kill the camel. تقاسموا بالله. You know the meaning تقاسموا بالله. They said we swear by Allah to kill it. You believe in Allah? You say, by Allah, I will kill the mu'jiza? Subhanallah. Very, very contradiction. قالوا تقاسموا بالله لنبيتنه غنة. لنبيتنه غنة وأهله ثم غنة لنقولن غنة لوليه ما شهدنا قلقلة مهلك أهله وإن غنة لصادقون. ومكروا مكرا ومكرنا مكرا. مكرا ومكرنا إضغام إذغنة. مكرا وهم إضغام إذغنة. So, سبحان الله, look the آيات. يعني سبحان الله, those who are making bad, they are believing in Allah. And they say, by Allah, who will do like this? So, سبحان الله, it means not anyone saying, I believe in Allah, is true believer. الإيمان. الإيمان. What is the definition of الإيمان in our عقيدة? What is the definition of إيمان? What is the إيمان in عقيدة? In our عقيدة. What is the definition of إيمان? Acceptance of Allah. It's very, very short. إيه continue. ها قول باللسان ده عقيدة أهل السنة. أهل السنة والجماعة that the definition of إيمان قول باللسان. قول باللسان means you say by tongue آمنت بالله. آمنت بالله. آمنت بالله. قول باللسان و believe in your heart وعمل بالجنان. believe in your heart وعمل بالأركان and to act according to the pillars of إيمان. So it's not only to say I am مؤمن. No, you have to show evidences that you are مؤمن. Like those people, they said والله by Allah we will do like this. But they did very bad. So you are not مؤمن. فانظر إخفاء حقيقي كيف كان عاقبة مكرهم أن غنة دمرناهم غنة وقومهم أجمعين قلقلة فتلك بيوتهم خاوية بما ظلموا. إقلاب. إقلاب. إقلاب ده تنوين will be meme. That's why written meme here. You can see meme. خاوية تم. خاوية تم. Of course after that we make إخفاء شفوي. إن غنى في ذلك لآية لقوم إضغام ذوي الغنة. قومي يعلمون إضغام الغنة. ولوطا إذ قال. لوطا إظهار. إظهار حلق. This one. إذ قال لقومه أتأتون الفاحشة وأنتم. أنتم إخفاء حقيقي. تبصرون قلقلة. أئنكم غنة لتأتون الرجال شهوة من إضغام غنة من دون إخفاء حقيقي النساء غنة عندن مد واجب متصل فور حركات بل أنتم إخفاء حقيقي قوم تجهلون إخفاء حقيقي عندن قلقلة. Of course I know some of you maybe not understand the rules of Tajweed 100%. This يعني normal, don't worry. But if you today, alhamdulillah, you get one rule, two rule, good. Then next week, inshallah, you get one more. Then step by step, you will be, inshallah, perfect. So alhamdulillah, we finished this page. And inshallah, if you have any questions, okay. If you have any questions, yes. Yes. وتصديق بالجنان. تصديق بالجنان. Means to have a belief in your heart. تصديق بالجنان. وعمل بالأركان. قول باللسان. قول باللسان. وتصديق بالجنان. وعمل بالأركان. Yes. إن شاء الله. Any other question? If not, we will go to the hadith. As I said to you, this book, Riyadu al-Salihin. Riyadu al-Salihin. Very nice book. And I hope, inshallah, every one of you can have this Riyadu al-Salihin. A lot of hadith, and most of the hadith, sahiha, correct. Okay? Not like some other books full of hadith, but most of the hadith are not sahiha. This dangerous. Hadith, brother Afif, today, chapter 4. The name of the chapter. After number 4, okay? Number 4, inshallah. So if you can show the brothers, will be good. So today, we'll have one hadith in this chapter, number 4. Number 4. Truthfulness. Truthfulness means to say the truth. Truthfulness. To be saying the truth. So now the brother, inshallah, he will try to show you the hadith. You can see this chapter 4. Truthfulness, number 4. Okay, this the chapter. Okay, chapter name. Then, as I told you, in this book, Alhamdulillah, Imam al-Nawawi, he start by ayat and then ahadith. So he started by 1, 2, 3 ayat. Surah At-Tawbah 119. Surah Al-Ahzab 35. Surah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam 21. 3 ayat. Okay. Those ayat talking about the importance of truthfulness, to be always saying the truth. Not to saying lies. Okay? Astaghfirullah. And then after that, the hadith. So the first ayah, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu attaqullah wa kunu ma'a as-sadiqin. O you who believe, the mu'mineen, be afraid of Allah, يعني اتقوا الله. Be afraid of Allah and be with those who are true, who are saying the truth. Okay. The second ayah, والصادقين والصادقات الأحزاب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this very long ayah actually, but Imam al-Nawawi, he took الصادقين والصادقات. The men and women who are truthful, always saying the truth, not lies. Ayah number 3, Surah Muhammad. فَلَوْ صَدَقُوا اللَّهَ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ. سورة محمد 21. Then if they had been true to Allah, it would have been better for them. Now we'll go to the hadith. Only we take the first hadith. Hadith 54. عن ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن الصدق يهدي إلى البر وإن البر يهدي إلى الجنة وإن الرجل ليصدق حتى يكتب عند الله صديقا وإن الكذب يهدي إلى الفجور وإن الفجور يهدي إلى النار وإن الرجل ليكذب حتى يكتب عند الله كذابا. متفق عليه. This hadith narrated by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ الصِّدْقَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْبِرِّ. When you always train yourself and your tongue to always say the truth, even some people don't like, but you train your tongue only to say the truth, not to say lies. Okay? This will lead you to al-birr. When you always say truth, it will leading you to birr. What is the meaning of al-birr? Al-birr means everything good. This one word, al-birr. In Arabic language, al-birr. Only one word. But the meaning of al-birr, unlimited. Any of the good deeds. Okay, al-birr. Then al-birr leads you to Jannah. Okay, and when you are always saying truth, Allah will write you as a truthful person. Okay, in the other side, وَإِنَّ الْكَذِبِ, but a person when saying lies, okay, it's guiding to fujur, bad deeds, and the fujur guiding to Jahannam. And a person always talking lies, and he will be written as a liar. Okay, this is the meaning of the hadith. So of course, the ayat and the hadith encouraging us always to be truthful, always saying truth, not to say lies. If we want to be more near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to be, inshallah, from the people of Jannah.